Hi, my name is Marilyn Doué. I am a PhD student in Lille in a French academic laboratory headed by Professor Desrevaux. In our lab, we try to understand mechanisms implicated in inflammatory bowel disease like Crohn's disease and ulcerative colitis. Factors involved in the onset of inflammation are still poorly known. To date, animal models of inflammatory bowel disease focus on colonic lesions, and few models of ileitis are available. During my PhD, I associated in an animal model three important factors suspected to play a role in the onset of inflammation to create an ileal inflammation model. I was particularly interested in the intestinal flora, which was demonstrated to be crucial in the development of intestinal inflammation. Moreover, a disturbance of intestinal flora has been observed in Crohn's disease patients. Indeed, ileal lesions of these patients showed an important colonization by a new patobar of Escherichia coli termed adherent and invasive Escherichia coli, AIEC. Moreover, not two mutations, an intracytoplasmic receptor involved in bacterial prions and in antimicrobial peptide secretion, are risk factors for ileal Crohn's disease and were associated with an abnormal AIEC-induced immune response. Finally, the intestinal flora, abundant in the digestive tract, plays a protective role toward pathogens' invasion. Studies show a correlation between antibiotics consumption and the onset of Crohn's disease. Thus, we decide to associate these three factors, node mutation, AIEC, and antibiotic, to set up an animal model of ileal inflammation. In our protocol, intestinal flora destruction was induced by two broad-spectrum antibiotics administered by gavage for 3 days, followed by 2 days of oral infection with AIEC LF82. Non-infected animals and infected animals without preliminary antibiotic treatment were used as control. At D0, D30, and D60, ileum, colon, mesenteric fat, and mesenteric lymph nodes are sampled to study AIEC colonization and translocation and to evaluate intestinal inflammation. Our result first indicates that in absence of antibiotic treatment, LF82 is unable to colonize ileum and colonic epithelium of wild-type and non-tuber mice at D0, D30, and D60. However, intestinal flora destruction induced by antibiotics led to a significant increase of LF82 colonization in ileum and colonic epithelium in wild-type and non-tuber mice at D0, as shown at blue bar. The intestinal flora was deeply disrupted, as shown by the increase of lactobacillus flora observed at D0 in the colon and the ileum of mice. Persistent colonization of LF82 was still observed at D30 only in the ileum of wild-type and non-tuber mice treated by antibiotic, as shown with red bars, confirming the ileal tropism of our model. LF82 translocation in mesenteric fat and mesenteric lymph nodes was observed at D0 in wild-type and non-tuber mice treated by antibiotics, but persist at D30 only in non-tuber mice, underlining the importance of NOD2 in the preservation of intestinal integrity. Nevertheless, LF82 was not anymore detected at D60 in the intestinal flora of mice, and no sign of histological or molecular inflammation was observed during the experiment in mice treated by antibiotics and infected by LF82. In conclusion, wild-type and non-tuber mice were standardly resistant to LF82 infection. The commensal intestinal flora imbalance induced by a short-term antibiotic treatment allowed the colonization of ileal epithelium by LF82 independently of NOD2 expression. In contrast, the intestinal flora disruption induced by antibiotics allowed a long-term LF82 bacterial translocation in a NOD2-dependent manner. Thus, LF82 does not seem to play a determinant role in the onset of intestinal inflammation. An implication in the phenomenon of relapse could be envisaged.